in brief, the NUSEP programs, according to the documentation and the report from the lead patron, it is a project to equip students in northern Uganda with some vocational skill that should be able to help them when they leave schools. We are happy as the administration in that the area of skill provision which they have selected was really in the support of the school, like agriculture. The school this year had made agriculture now compulsory, school farming, electricity and electronic. We realized that would be from a better background for the learners to begin doing hand-on practice and also add on to their knowledge. And for arts, this is where students have got a lot of interest and they have been doing it very well. So somehow it is like Yaden has known the interest of some of our students.
Club generally there are 74 members. We have tried to come out with this to imagine how it looks like. Okay. Practically, we have done it ourselves. As we proceed in life, I think we shall be now actually helping with you, as you can even see. You shall be knowing that if you do this, this one will be meaning rich, iron sheets, then you get the things that we do.
Okay, to add on to what you said, I think that from the skills that we have so far learned from doing this, to learn from the outside world, even get jobs. Because when you have these skills, these necessary skills in building, you cannot be able to do certain things that a layman cannot be able to do. So this one can even help us learn to earn a living.
Okay.
As we proceed with our school.
Okay. We are first learning.
Yeah.
Because this power requires a lot of material.
Yeah.
For example, as you can see, this model is out of laptop.
Yeah.
So the materials are like, there are some materials which are sharp that can cut you, but when you are cutting this laptop, to make the model.
Another challenge, a very big one actually, is that to come up with this needs a lot of time and
devotion.
Yes. You have to give it all your best, to do it the best, so that it can come up with something beautiful like this.
Okay.
Otherwise, if you don't give your time, it will never be possible.
Good. In addition to what they have said,
yes,
making this chat box has been good for the material.
Yeah.
This one is better with the chat box.
That is, yeah.
Getting them with my
skills. Okay. Thank you for that.
Designing.
Okay.
You have also acquired the skill of making collage.
Yes, learn how to paint.
First of all,
yes,
the reason why I joined this club is because I want, in future, I want to be self-employed.
We use hand business for decorating our house.
Yes. The major challenge which we are facing is the time. Time was not enough for us to complete. That is why some of the art pieces are not yet completed.
So far, so good. Some challenges that we are also facing was challenges of our paint. The paints were not enough for us.
I kindly request the Garden States to at least provide us with some of the materials.
There is not enough of the place where we should keep our materials. But in school there, we don't have enough space for them. And as you can see, some of them are even broken. So we need something like a room where we can keep our
Yes. Kindly, I want to say this to my brothers and sisters, that please come and join us in creative arts club. Because in future, you may not know. You may be employed, or you may end up what? Unemployed.
So it's like, you don't know. Yeah. Expensive arts materials are expensive, yeah? And it pays to be our products.
Yes.
Like some products come, they expect it to be our products. Yeah.
And others were turned up, but others were not turned up. We would see them.
They have dried up, then we decided to draft another one.
Okay.
That's why some survived, some.
Ah.
I think teachers also should act their role of teaching it in class or for us during sport time.
Yeah.
Yeah. They gather two students.
About market surveys.
Learn many skills.
Yes.
Of how to operate a business and how to start it from what you are having.
Yes.
Yeah.
My name is Lakisa Charity John and I'm in Guluhami Secondary School. I'm in Creative Heart Club and this is what we do. And being in Creative Heart Club, it has made me to gain the experience and the knowledge on how to do mosaic, how to paint. So I was like the previous time I painted and I did mosaic, I sold them and I've got money. So I know that it will also help me in future to get money, also to self-employ me. And also not only that, it can also help me in various ways. I can also teach those other people who don't know how to do mosaic. I can teach them, then we form a club and also become creative artists like me. Okay, it was a very small painting, so I sold it at only 15,000, which is the money I used. I topped it on my school fees and I paid with my fees. So I know that if I keep on doing like that, so soon I'll not even be disturbing my mom to pay for my school fees. I'll just do it by myself, because this is not even something very difficult, not also very easy. Just on how you put your heart and your determination, you can make it very well. Definitely, I will continue with it, because I know that is like part of me. I cannot put it aside. Since I've gained the experience and the knowledge in it, know that I'll do even much more better.
Name Aquin Morris, Senior 5 student, member of Skills and Building Club, Guluhami Secondary School. I come from Peche. Down there division. I have a mother. My father has died when I was very young. I cannot remember, but I was told he died. So that's all I can say about my family. Actually, I have gained a lot from the club. Because one, as you can see, when I can construct now a real house. the real house out there looks like, apart from this one now, plus these other knowledges we have been getting from school and others from outside as well. Okay, skills that I've learned from the building and skills club will help me in constructing house even actually, and other architectural work in the future.
Looking onto the commitment of the student in this school in particular, actually, in my feeling, it would be better if more students should be encouraged to undertake this different vocational training. And in the same way for Northern Uganda, that is an area that they can benefit on. The area like agriculture, the area like these hand-on activities, fine art, it is an area which need to be really greatly emphasized, so that students who may not be able, because of the economics ground, they are not able maybe to proceed with their study, at least they would be having somewhere to go and really do something that can hand them a living. To me, it would really help more of our youngsters if it is extended to all the secondary schools, to all the vocational schools, and to all, even primary school at higher level. I think if more students should be encouraged to do this, I think a school would be also to plan for them, to give them support in terms of maybe those areas that they can meet. And then also The time for training, the report from the patron is that it has been too short. Almost things are supposed to be done within 3-4 months, and sometimes become difficult on them. And also, it was not there in the school program, so it required the school program also to be adjusted. But if it is going to be promoted, it will make the school to make it officially in their programs, and even the parent know, so that is well supported. The percentage dropout, I would say, is great, like because on a yearly basis, we admit not less than 400 students in Senior 1. But when you are sitting in Senior 4, they don't sit more than 120. With the exception of this year, that we had to request UNEP to allow us expand on our center.
That's
and
about,
still,
that's about 75 to 80%.
Almost. It is a very, very high rate.
Yeah.
And at the moment, it is lowering to maybe 50, because the school has no structures. And as you can also see, some of the structures, they are not really so fitting for study. Okay, the issue that are on record now filed, like for the girl child, sometimes they drop off, and when they get impregnated by maybe their peers, so that one make them drop out. While for the boys, it is mostly the finance. They get defeated to pay the little that the school demand, and they end up dropping out. So those are the two basic reasons. I believe if somebody was joined right in Senior 1, after practicing in that club for a year, probably due to the holidays, that child would be able to supplement the little income from the parent to make him or her remain in school. Hello.